A festival of colors. Thousands of people, young and old, are gathered here this beautiful morning, waiting for the starting pistol.
More and more Chinese people want to live a healthy lifestyle, and this is driving a demand in traditional and modern sports. One of them is running, and what better way to enjoy that than joining the fun at the Color Run here in Beijing.
Apparently, there's much more to sport than just getting fit and staying healthy.
With a growing passion for sports here in China, sportswear is also becoming a fashion trend.
In 2023, China's sports consumption market was valued at around $200 billion. That's expected to double in 3 years. Chinese sports brands are getting the picture. But how are they leveraging on it? This is Jinjiang, China's shoe capital. One in every 20 pairs of shoes in the world is manufactured here. That's over 1 billion pairs each year. Yet, little more than 40 years ago, Jinjiang was just an impoverished town on China's southeast coast. What's the secret behind its success? Chen Radian is the president of the local Chamber of Commerce. He tells me that to understand the Jinjiang story, I should learn a song, Fight to Win.
Why do you like this song?
其实每个闽南人，特别是闽南的老板，都非常喜欢这首歌。特别是你在生意上遇到曲折、遇到一些不顺的情况下，这个歌它可以激励你往前冲。三分天注定。
I could not understand every word, but the way he sang the song, I could feel how the people of Jinjiang fought hard to get to where they are today.
我是等于是前代的发展的第一代，那时候我那出来的时候18岁，我们吃过的苦多了。 那我们要骑着一个计程车，有时候一天骑到厦门同安，因为厦门同安有做学院的，骑到厦门去销售。
1978 was a turning point for China. It announced its reform and opening up to reshape its economy. Chen dared to dream. But back in the day, it was not easy for private entrepreneurs to join the big boys.
那个时候我们去推销嘛，那卖都是到百货公司、百货店去买嘛。然后百货店还是公家的，他对看你这个个体户是非常看不起的。那我们包里面拿几双样品，经常都被他们赶出来，理都不理你啊！你们这个不要，都是这种。
The tables have turned now. Private entrepreneurs have contributed significantly to make China the world's second largest economy. The private sector accounts for 90% of businesses in China and provides 80% of the jobs here.
其实我们陈大人的一个优点就是会吃苦。 赖劳，还有一个就相互比拼。我要做得更好，我要争一口气。 所以遇到了很大的困难，我们都是这样一路在想，继续在抢，在冲，没有说我要退出了。
Market economy reforms were a boon to private entrepreneurs like Chen. Quickly, Jinjiang grew to become a national hub of the footwear industry.
到了应该90年代，秦代就有几千家了，每一。各村最少都有100多家的企业，因为成立一个全国都到秦代这边来采购。
As the market continued to flourish, it generated an aggregation effect. From raw material procurement to production and sales, tens of thousands of enterprises sprung up in Jinjiang, forming a complete production chain and industrial system.Jinjiang began to make its mark on the international stage to become a global footwear hub. Simultaneously, dozens of towns across the country, echoing Jinjiang's success, began to emerge as dynamic industrial hubs. Like an ecosystem, watching these small and big fishes, it just reminds me of how small and big companies in Jinjiang work together efficiently. However, Jinjiang's fish, big and small, were in for a shock. The Great Recession in 2008 threw a spanner in the works.
过去呢，我们可以出口，全世界市场都是对我们开放的。但是金融危机之后呢，全世界的需求增速啊，它下来，那我们就得要转型。
Jinjiang's entrepreneurs recognized the need for a major change in strategy. From design and manufacturing to quality and branding, the traditional industries needed an upgrade. Across China, entrepreneurs began creating world-famous brands for the domestic market, focusing on higher quality and better design.This logistics center is operated by a local sports brand. During China's biggest shopping festival, Double 11, it handles 1 million orders a day. Among the sneakers flying off its shelves, many bear the touch of American designer Robbie Fuller.
Wow.
Oh,
what? Seriously?So, I mean, for me, this is what an amazing moment. Yeah. Out here, you know, like maybe in that box,
yeah.
something I designed.
Possibly you could have designed,
in that
yeah.
box, something that somebody from my team's designed.
Right, right.
And each time that thing moves, it's like somebody somewhere said, hey, I want something you've designed. So, yeah. pretty cool moment. Looking at these people.
From designing his first pair of shoes at Converse to senior design director at Adidas,Robbie became a leading figure in footwear design. In 2016, he made the move to China.
So big question, why China?
As part of being a footwear designer, you need to go to where the product's being made. You need to see the samples, make updates. For me, I feel this pressure at all times. As soon as I get the sample, immediately it's like, what do you want to change? you know? And so for you, you quickly look at it and you go, oh, yeah, I agree. This part could be better. This could be better. You make those changes, get them out. Boom, here comes the next round and the next round. So unlike any other place in the world, literally for two years, we had this theme, Faster China. And this was one of the authentic reasons why we really liked that theme, because it's faster, moving forward, high performance, high technology. So yeah, the pace is unbelievable.
At this state-of-the-art manufacturing facility, creative designs are being transformed into products faster than ever before.Different categories, styles, colors, and sizes of shoes and clothing are being produced on the same production line at the same time.
中国经济最显著的变化就是从这种外延式扩张的发展模式转向了高质量发展。什么是高质量发展道路呢？就是要搞技术创新。
I definitely like some of this. Changes color.
How make these sleeves totally different?
When I hold this and do like that, you can tell something kind of.
And that focus is definitely paying off. In 2022, Anta's revenue surpassed Nike's in China for the first time, making it the largest sports footwear and apparel company in the country.
Trends come and go, but winning is always cool. To be honest, that was one of the reasons I wanted to come and do this role in China. And so being able to play any kind of role in that, I think I'll look back on it and, you know, feel a sense of pride.
In the past 40 years, pride, persistence, and entrepreneurship have become the hallmark of this city. Just like Anta, more companies are starting out small and growing into giant whales in the ocean we call the global marketplace.
We know that the world's biggest market economy is the majority of the world. But the majority of the world's biggest market economy do not succeed. 所以市场经济呢，它是一个必要条件，但它绝对不是一个经济增长的充分条件。所以还是要看你这个政府怎么去搞改革，怎么去制定政策。因为中国政府呢，在这方面呢，做的呢是非常好的。As
part of its continuous efforts to deepen reform, China announced yet another new law in July 2024. Its aim is to boost the socialist market economy.